good afternoon, and welcome to Hydromantis webinar. We'll be talking about modeling aeration system in GPSX today. My name is Rajiv Goyal, and I have Spencer Snolling here with me, who is going to give you an update at the end of the webinar about some of the new events that are happening at Hydromantis. So today, the agenda that we have is talking about some of the aeration models that we have in GPSX. I'll be talking about oxygen transfer model, and followed by one of the new model that we have included in GPSX 6.5, which allows the user to model the air distribution head losses in air delivery model, air delivery systems in aeration tanks. I'll be showing you a demonstration of this particular model, and then we'll have some of the questions that might come from the users. So in modeling water resource recovery facilities, we are looking at modeling biological reactions, chemical reactions, and at the same time, another important aspect that we normally want to model is the oxygen. We want to include oxygen transfer models that can link the oxygen consumption that is happening in the biological systems to the oxygen transfer that takes place through aeration, and helps us determine air requirements, blower power, and the DO concentration in aeration tanks. The way normally, typically, the models handle oxygen transfer in the biological model is to include an oxygen transfer model that can allow user to either specify a set dissolved oxygen concentration in the aeration tank, which can help to determine the air flow rate, or specify the air flow rate from where the dissolved oxygen concentration can be calculated. So in this particular model, we are not modeling any of the head losses that may happen in the air delivery system. Recently, there has been some interest in modeling the air delivery systems and the head losses that may take place in the diffusers, drop pipes, in the distribution pipes, and to estimate based on that what is the blower pressure requirement. So to do that, we need another model that is we can call air delivery model, which can be used to estimate the head loss, the wall positions, the blower pressure, and the blower power in the system. So today I'll be talking about both of these models, oxygen transfer model, which we have discussed previously, but I'll just give you a little bit of a background on how the equations are set up in GPSX, and then followed by the air delivery model, which is a new implementation in GPSX 6.5. So to model oxygen transfer in the system, we start with writing a mass balance equation with respect to a dissolved oxygen concentration in the system. And in this particular case, the rate of change of oxygen is given by the oxygen that is coming in, the mass of the oxygen that is coming in, the oxygen that is going out, and the oxygen that is added through the gas liquid transfer, and the biological reactions that are actually consuming the oxygen in the system is also a part of this equation. To model the concentration, dissolved oxygen concentration in the system, we need to work out what is the saturation concentration in the system, and also figure out what is the mass transfer rate for the oxygen in the system. So these two particular parameters that are calculated in the model, and these are the equations for those. So first one is the DO. Saturation concentration at a given temperature. So in GPSX, we start with the concentration of oxygen at 20 degrees C. So these are the concentrations database that we have inside GPSX. And then starting with that concentration, we are applying a temperature correction factor to take into account the temperature that may be different than the 20 degrees C. Also, there is a wastewater correction factor that is specified by the user, because all these concentrations that are specified are for the clean water system. Also, we apply a pressure correction factor that is appropriate depending on the height of the tank and as the pressure increases, the solubility of oxygen in the system increases. So we take into account that particular correction. The next parameter, which is the KLA estimation, starts with the estimation of the oxygen transfer rates in the system. So some of the equations that are used inside the model are described here. The first equation is basically estimation of the standard oxygen transfer rate, which we can estimate based on the airflow rates that are either determined or calculated by the system, and multiplying it by the density of the air and the standard oxygen transfer efficiencies, which are provided by the user and are the properties of a given aeration system. So we do have some correlations for different aeration systems that can be used to estimate the standard oxygen transfer efficiencies in the aeration tanks. So after calculation of standard oxygen transfer efficiency, we are estimating oxygen transfer rates, which are basically calculated by applying some of the correction factors, like depth correction factor and the alpha wastewater correction factor, the diffuser fouling factor, and the temperature correction factor. So these factors are user-specified. Some of them are user-specified. For example, alpha and the fouling factor are user-defined, where the delta factor, which is a depth correction factor, is calculated based on the pressure differences and the depth of the aeration tank. So once we have determined the oxygen transfer rate, we can use the standard equation for estimating KLA. So oxygen transfer rate divided by the driving force divided by the volume of the tank can lead us to estimation of KLA. The application of the model can be in different ways. So we can start with the airflow rate. So user can specify airflow rate, and we can estimate the KLA and the DO in the system using the oxygen transfer model. We can also start with DO set point and estimate the KLA and the airflow rates, or we also allow for user to enter direct KLA values based on which we can estimate airflow rate and DO concentration in the system. So some of the advanced features of the oxygen transfer model in GPSX are that we can estimate standard oxygen transfer efficiencies based on some well-defined correlations, which are based on airflow rates, diffuser depth, type of diffuser, and diffuser density in the system. Also, we allow default values of alpha that can be different for different diffuser technologies. So there are some default values for different aeration technologies that are already provided inside GPSX as different default values for alpha factor. We also allow a user to specify different alpha values for different compartments of flux flow tank. So user can change the values as the wastewater passes through different compartments. Also, there are some advanced PID controllers for DO controls, and very sophisticated control systems can be built for controlling DO using these PID controllers. The functions that are also available are for the calculation of the blower power and energy requirement in the system. Now, coming to our second topic, and the main topic of today's presentation is how do we model the air delivery system in GPSX. So this is a very schematic representation of a typical system that might exist at a field. And to start with, basically what we have done is trying to make a model representation of this system and try to capture the essential components of this system and represent it on the diagram on the right hand side. The conceptualization in this particular way is coming from the paper published by Gray and Castle in 2013. It's a WEFTEC paper which highlights some of the air delivery system modeling in aeration tanks. So in this particular simplification or representation, what we are trying to do is estimate the head losses that take place at the diffusers. Also the head loss that take place in the drop pipes or the distribution pipes, and then in the main header to the aeration system there. So we are calculating all the head losses in the pipes, in the diffusers, and also in the valve here. And there are some mechanisms that are there to estimate the losses, head losses that take place in the fittings and the fittings, and the minor losses that take place in the fittings in the distribution system. So I'll be talking about some of the equations that we have used to estimate the pressure head losses in different components of this air delivery system. So to start with the diffuser head losses here, so we did some literature review and the research and trying to figure out the head loss properties of different diffusing elements in the different diffusers in aeration tanks. And this is a table that comes from Aeration Wastewater Treatment Processes, a manual of practice, it highlights some of the minimum and maximum air flows that are permitted from four different diffuser systems, and also some of the head losses, expected head losses that take place in these systems. So if we plot a typical head loss graph for a diffuser system, as the air flows are increasing, which are expressed as meter cube per day per diffuser, the head loss tends to keep on increasing. So to represent this kind of curves in GPSX, we have allowed user to specify 15 data points for any given distribution head loss for a diffuser head loss curve. So we have some default table that we have provided in the model, but user can definitely modify these values based on any spatial or any different nature of this curve that they may get from the manufacturer. For modeling air delivery pipe head loss, the equation that we used to model the head losses in the pipes is coming from Kasim 1999, one of the well-referenced handbook there. So in this one, we are estimating, we can see that the head loss is dependent on the length of the pipe, the airflow, and the diameter of the pipe. And as we can notice that the inverse relationship with diameter and raised to power 5 makes it a very significant factor. So it's very sensitive to the diameter of the pipe. In this particular equation, we need to estimate the friction factor and also the temperature of the air that is flowing through the system. So we are trying to estimate those friction factor using one of the equation described here, also available in Kasim 1999. And the pressure that, and the temperature that we are estimating is based on the pressure in the system, and just using the relationship between temperature and pressure there. So this is the equation that we are using. Also, to model the minor fitting head losses, we are allowing user to specify the length of those fittings directly into the model. And once the length is specified, we are then using the equation that is there for the pipe head loss. So that's the way we have modeled the minor fitting head losses in the system. For the valve head loss model, we have used the equation that is proposed by Crane 1999 and also used by Gray and Castle in 2013 paper. So this particular equation is based on valve discharge coefficient, which is linked to the airflow rate and the specific gravity of the air, the temperature of the air, and then the inlet pressure and the outlet pressure. So in this particular equation, if we know the discharge valve discharge coefficient, then we can try to figure out the head losses that are taking place in the valve. So we need to figure out what is the value of this discharge coefficient here. And there are, the discharge coefficient is kind of for different valves, there are many different different relationships between valve opening position and what is the discharge coefficient for the valve. So some of the equations that we have built into the model now is the is a linear relationship in which the valve position is directly, the valve position is the flow discharge coefficient is a direct relationship with the valve position. Then we have equal percentage equation, which is something like this, hyperbolic equation and exponent equation and the square root equation. So if we look at the behavior of this different equations, we can see that they are modeling, they can be appropriate for modeling many different kind of valves. So in this particular case, this is a relationship for a linear relationship. This is a hyperbolic relationship. So we can see that the discharge properties up to a certain valve positions are not changing so much, but then after that particular value, it starts to change significantly. So a user can choose between any one of these models and try to use those models in the head loss systems. So now coming to the mode of operations, there are two modes that a user can select. One is the, we can start with a set pressure, blower pressure, and then we can adjust the valve positions. We can estimate the valve positions for a given flow rates that are given going into the aeration tanks. Also, the other mode of operation is we adjust the valve position such that there is at least one valve which is at the most open valve condition, and then we estimate what is the pressure requirement at the blower side. So these are the two mode of operations that are applicable. I would like to show you one of the model applications that that can highlight the application use of this particular model. So in this particular layout, we have an aeration tank with a air delivery system, and if we look at the schematic of this, a representation of this, there are four distribution pipes associated with the four tanks that are there in series. And in this particular setup, what we have done is the size of this second, third, and fourth pipes are significantly lower than the pipe size that is for the first tank, in which large amount of air is expected to come in. We tested this model with a diurnal flow, expected diurnal flow that may come at the influent and feeding, changing the loading to the aeration tank and visualizing what are the changes with respect to the estimated pressure at the blower. So typical outputs, so in this one we can look at the blower pressure changes with respect to the same as the variation in the influent flow there. And the maximum pressure that we encounter here is 1.66 atmosphere. And if we look at the graph, the variation between the maximum and the minimum pressure is something of the order of 10% here. Also looking at the valve position, since we are working with the most open valve concept, one of the valve which is happens to be the tank number 2 valve is the most open, and the rest of the valves are adjusted in such a way that there is a constant pressure at the common point of the distribution system. So the results from the constant pressure or the second mode of operation, so we are running this system as a constant pressure of 1.8 atmosphere. So in this case, we can estimate what are the valve positions required to maintain a stable pressure in the system. So when we analyze the head loss analysis for this particular case, for the most open valve concept, then in that particular case, we notice that the biggest head loss that is taking place because we specified a very small pipe or smaller size pipe for the second, third, and fourth tanks. The head loss taking place in those areas, basically the minor head losses and the pipe head losses, they were the highest for the second tank, while to balance the pressure, the valve needed to be completely open so that the head losses at the valve could be minimized. So from this analysis, it appears that there could be, by changing probably the pipe size for the second tank, there could be some significant savings energy in the energy consumption that could be achieved. So I'll give you a very quick demonstration of the GPSX just to show how this model, you can access this model, and how can you set it up. So this is a layout that we have, a whole plan layout, whole plan model for a particular treatment plan that we have built here. So in this particular case, if you have 6.5, you can go to the suspended growth processes here, and you would see another new object, which is a plug flow tank with aeration header. So this is a tank that you would like to, if you want to model the air delivery system, this is a tank that you would like to place on the drawing board here. So in this particular case, you can see there is a small header, air delivery header, that is built into the object. So if you click on this object, we can look at the air delivery system parameters that I just described. So we can look at, for example, how do we specify the diffuser head loss curve. So there are 15 points. You can choose lower number of points here. If you don't want to specify 15 points, you can you can reduce the number of points. So when you go here, the user can enter all this information and change the default values that we have specified. With respect to the diameter of the drop pipe, so there are four tanks, as I said, so we can specify the diameter of the drop pipes. And in this particular situation, as I said, the diameter of the drop pipe for the first tank is 100 millimeter, and for the second, third, and fourth, we intentionally reduce it to 50 millimeter there. So also the length of the drop pipe can be specified very, very easily through this click button there. For the minor losses, as I said, we can specify the equivalent length to take into account the head losses that are taking place in the fittings. Also, for the air control valve, we have different equations that I just described: the linear equation, equal percentage, hyperbolic, exponent, and the square root equation. And each one of them have their own CV max that needs to be specified. For the main delivery header, so we have the size of the main delivery header and the length of the main delivery header. Also, for the main delivery header, we can also have some equivalent settings for the minor losses that may take place in the main delivery header. Finally, how the system is being operated, whether it's a most open valve control or whether it's a pressure set point, can be selected from this particular options that are available to the user. So if we run this particular model, we can see, we can go to, for example, most open valve. So we are into the most open valve system. And of course, this particular setting is not valid in this particular case. So the system is going to run for about 1 day of diurnal flow that we have set it up for. And we can see that how the blower pressure is changing in the system. And we can also see which one is the most open valve. So in this particular case, the most open valve is the number 2 valve. And this is the diurnal pattern of the influent flow that is being fed to the system. If we look at the valve positions, we can see that the valve position for the second one is the most open valve, and for the other three compartments, the model is estimating what should be the valve position to balance the pressure there. So if we run, for example, the other setting, which is a constant pressure, in this particular case, the pressure has been set to 1.7 atmosphere, and we can see how the system behaves in that particular situation. So when we are running in the most open valve condition, then in that case, of course, we can the pressure is changing while keeping one of the valve or one of the line which is actually having the most pressure drop. So having the most open valve there so that we can reduce the pressure and save the energy. On the other side, when we are running the system with a constant pressure, We can see that the blower pressure are now constant at 1.7, but the valve positions are now changing, and none of the valve is at 0.8 or that's the maximum position that we are allowing in this particular model. So we are estimating all these positions here. So I guess the model is model allows the user to let's go back to the slides there. The model allows the user to model the head losses in different elements of air distribution system. And the only information, or the information, not the only information, but the information that is required to model the systems is, first of all, we need to do a little bit of understanding of the distribution system, then translate it into a model structure that can fit to the model, to the schematic that I described, and then also find out what are the airflow rate and the diffuser head loss relationships, and what are the valve characteristics that are probably available from the manufacturers, and choose the operational conditions, and then you can analyze your system. So in summary, I'd like to kind of summarize the whole presentation here. In GPSX 6.5, we have an aeration model that can model both oxygen transfer at the same time the air delivery system. We have advanced PID controllers that can be used to optimize, evaluate, and optimize aeration systems. And the new air delivery model can be used to evaluate control valve positions, the head loss, the blower pressure, and the power calculations for the blower based on the pressures that are calculated. So with this, I would like to hand it over to Spencer, who is going to give you some information on some of the events that are happening at Hydromantis.